Hey, welcome to my channel. So, we're going to be talking about Laplace transform today. This is sort of the first lesson during the quarantine that I'm going to be doing. And so it's to be one of several pieces to wrap up the differential equations class we've been going through. I'm going to put this on my general channel so that other professors and stuff can use this. So if you're my student, you know, please reserve any comments and stuff like that for Canvas. And so that way we can avoid any sort of privacy issues. Laplace transform, what is this? This is a special transform that came out of, I think it was like the 1930s by Pierre something at Laplace. And he was studying what are called generating functions and led into this work on the Laplace transform. You don't need to know any of that, and that's fine. What is the goal of using the Laplace transform is to change a differential equation to an algebraic equation so that you can use the tools of algebra to solve the problem rather than the tools of calculus. This transformation basically takes one function to another function and with a set different sort of domain. Usually you think of it in terms of taking a function of time to a function of, say, frequency, which we will denote by S versus T. The term frequency comes from the Laplace transform's cousin, which is the Fourier transform, and they're actually rather closely related. And the Laplace transform itself falls under a general category of transform methods called Gelfand transforms, but that is way beyond anything you'll ever need to know. It is a nice example of a transform that's easy to get hold of in a 2000 level differential equations class, and it'll give you sort of an idea of how these transforms work so that when you go and, say, take signal processing and you learn about the Fourier transform there, a lot of these same ideas are still relevant. Also, if you go on to control theory, you will be using the Laplace transform there. People who take circuits will use the Laplace transform there. If you look at a typical circuits book, do I have anything? So for instance, I have the Nielsen-Riddell book here, and if you go through it, chapter 13 is all about Laplace transform and circuit analysis, and so this usually comes up when you do circuits too. So it's a very important topic, and most of my students, being engineering students, are going to have this come up again at some point. This is actually how people are going to solve differential equations to a large extent past this point, and they will use information that you gain through the Laplace transform to do things like design controllers that will stabilize a linear system and do basic analysis in PID controllers and so forth. So this is where you start to learn, and this is a very important topic. So Laplace transforms are easy to work with, but you're going to have a few tools from elementary calculus to really get your head around them. One tool that you need from elementary calculus is improper integrals. We're going to be taking integrals from 0 to infinity, and so and you'll also need to, you know, refresh yourself on things like integration by parts and solving for the integral, especially when we take the Laplace transforms of sine and cosine. Another tool that you will need comes from calculus too. And it's really just a sort of pre-calculus or algebra sort of thing, but it's partial fraction decomposition. We're gonna end up having a lot of rational functions that we're gonna wanna break down and into their individual components. And this is gonna need to use this tool. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna develop a table of Laplace transforms of a whole variety of functions. And when we solve a differential equation using the Laplace transform method, we're going to be left with a whole collection of rational functions that we're going to want to be able to invert back from. And so we're going to use this table to transition there and back, and we'll have another table that we develop that's going to be focused completely on properties of the Laplace transform. Things like how do we get from a differential equation and to an algebraic equation all comes through this table. So so that's what this class is going to be all about. And I hope you'll find these lectures useful. And hopefully, if there's a professor out there who is working on, who is teaching a differential equations class and they're having some trouble transitioning to an online component, they can use these lectures too to help fill in the gap for the wrap-up doing the Laplace transform. And anyway, best of luck to your learning, and I'll see you on the next video.